السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. As we continue with our series From Deed to Habit, I'd like to talk a little bit about the morning dua. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, tells us that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, peace and blessings be upon him, used to begin his day by saying a particular prayer. أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله والحمد لله لا شريك له لا إله إلا هو وإليه النشور. So what does this mean? Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم starts by saying, I have arisen and the creation around me, الملك, has arisen for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We can use this as we wake up, we open our eyes, and as the birds are chirping and animals and creation are all praying in their various ways, we say Alhamdulillah. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's ultimately a start of our day that is aligned with our purpose on this earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that He has created mankind, humankind, and jinn, but to worship. And that's precisely what we do by beginning our day saying Alhamdulillah, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising Him. And also, in recognition of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's reminder, in his hadith, من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه معافا في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, whoever of us wakes up safe in their abode, healthy in their body, and has the provision for that day, then it's as if the entire world and all of its blessings have been brought forth for him. SubhanAllah. And so we start our day by saying Alhamdulillah. And we continue. La sharika lah. La ilaha illa hu. We tell ourselves that there is no deity worthy, that there is no association worthy of anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when we orient ourselves and we decide what we're going to prioritize for that day, when we decide what we're going to put our resources towards, our time, our energies, what we're going to put first on that to-do list, we tell ourselves that nothing goes above what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing goes above that purpose and that devotion to what ultimately is directed towards Him. That we have our eyes on the prize and our mind on the goal. And that is our akhirah. That is the pleasure of our Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we devote our heart and our soul towards that. And we tell ourselves that after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the beginning of the day. And then we end by saying, La ilaha illa huwa wa ilayhi an-nushur. That to Him is the resurrection. To remind ourselves what? Of the outcome. Where we're going. So we start by fulfilling that purpose. We remind ourselves that there's no association, nothing that can mess with one's heart, no pursuit of wealth, no relationship that is above Him. And ultimately, by reminding ourselves of where we're headed, the outcome. Because when we have our mind oriented towards that, we're able to spend our resources, which are our time and our health and our energy, in the direction of those priorities. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who are able to remember those priorities, who are able to live them and truly have them reflect in their day. And I want to give you two tips, two things to think about in inshallah keeping us on the habit of saying this dua. The first is to actually write this dua down. Spend the time taking it down and write it on something that you can put in your room. Perhaps you put it next to your bed or in front of on the bathroom door before you walk in so you can see it, so that you remember in the morning to say it. The second thought is to spend some time, sit down, and write a list of what your priorities are. You know, the Prophet ﷺ often would remind us to think of that finality, that outcome, which ultimately is our death and meeting our Lord. When we think about that, what are the things that truly surface? 3 to 5 priorities that we have that we want to focus on in our life. And then after finishing that, spend some time looking at your calendar. Do an assessment of your time. Look at throughout your day, how many hours are you devoting to various things? And then compare. Do those things align? How can I utilize this duha? And inshallah, come to cherish it, because it's that reminder of that prioritization and ensuring that the resources we put forth, the energy and the time and the health that we put forth towards our efforts is in fact oriented and aligned with the purpose of why we are here. May we be amongst those who are able to fulfill that, and may this month be blessed for all of you.